Shit, let me go get Chief, dog.
What's up?
Hey,
hey, my guy.
Got a lot of industry friends. That means I don't got no friends. Up in the M and the A, MIA. Think I went crazy. I got stupid. I got lazy. But I kept chasing a dry eye face. And I be in the basement with new innovations in the top flow. I ain't even got on my freshman. I was supposed to be on my sophomore. I was thinking my life.
What's up, guys? Matty Ice here, back with another video. I know it's been a while since I made a video, and I guess you could say I've just been doing a little bit of soul searching. I don't know if you would call it soul searching, but I've decided that I wanted to raise chickens. I wanted to be a chicken breeder. Yeah, if you guys see my videos in the past, you've probably seen that, where I talked about how my dad raises game fowl, and that my dad used to raise game fowl with his dad before he passed in Guam, when he was, being brought up as a kid and stuff like that. For you guys who do not know, that's where I'm from originally. If you guys do not know what Guam is just like an island. I would say kind of similar to Hawaii, and yeah, we do have Spanish, like, blood and stuff like that. That's why my last name's Perez or Betis, because, you know, just history, man. History is a mystery. What are you doing right now, bro?
Putting up their sauerkraut to help their digestive system.
He just came here from Hawaii not so long ago, like how long ago? 3 months ago. But yeah, we decided we want to be breeders. Is that right, bro?
No, I am a fucking breeder.
Yes, sir. That's the answer. That's the answer we like to hear. But yeah, we'll give you a little tour of what we got going on here at the Big P Game Camp. I have built this with my Nino, my godfather, recently, just to get a little pen for themselves. You know what I'm saying? We had this little lock system right here, just so that it keeps closed. I ended up adding this little lock system. You know what I mean? It just locks a little better. And in here, we got the first hatch of 2022 at the Big P Game Camp. These are pure Puerto Rican kikirikis, or pata cortas, or I don't know, there's another name for it. Again, like I said, guys, I'm pretty new to breeding. I'm originally from Guam. I don't speak any Spanish, or I don't even speak my language tomorrow. My dad speaks it, but there's a whole history shit to it, guys, you know what I'm saying? I've been trying to, like, grab them so that she can get used to me holding them and stuff, and she could trust me. My brother actually saved these guys, man. But yeah, guys, there's a cold front that came by. Here in Texas. Oh, look at this guy. But yeah, there's a co-friend that came by here in Texas, and I had lost one of the three chicks that we had, so we had moved her into a more isolated area. The next morning we had came out, it was still pretty cold, and we didn't have a heat lamp on them at all. I forgot, I didn't do it. Like I said, guys, it's my first time. And it sucks to learn, like, the hard way. My dad told me to, like, yo, you should move them. But, you know, I thought they would be fun. They actually were, like, starting to, like, stop moving and stuff. And I actually thought they were, like, dead. And then my brother Jose, he, like, was holding the chicks and stuff like that. He started, like, giving, I don't know. What would you say you were doing, bro?
CPR, motherfucker.
We ended up getting a lamp on them, but we had to heat them up ourselves. And, like I said, they were in a box, but not this one. This wasn't built yet. And, those are his babies, and his legs are actually shorter than her legs, and I have him with the old in his game hen.
Come here buddy.
Yeah, his color is, people say Pintu, Spangled. Yeah, he goes by Pintu or Spangled. I really like the Spangles, the dots, the polka dots. I really like them. He has like a beard around him. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, but when I had ordered him from Puerto Rico, I didn't see in the picture that he had a beard. I wasn't looking for a beard when I was, like, looking for birds. I don't really prefer it. But this little guy's beard has been rubbing off on me. Yeah, I don't know. I really like it. It's not that bad. He looks actually really handsome. What'd you say that is? Should we get a ruler? Should I get tape measure?
I mean, that's pretty self-explanatory. But your fingers aren't as big. Oh, you guys got about the same hands.
I don't know. I really like the Spangles. He's really cute. He's really nice.
Oh, short legs? Good tail?
The pure Puerto Rican kikiriki. Yeah, no, this is the first bird that I bought.
Mm-hmm.
This is the first bird that I bought, actually. Like, I'm colorblind, so a lot of times, like, I have to ask breeders, like, what color is it and stuff like that, because I can't really tell sometimes. And yeah, I'm just showing y'all some of the birds I got. I've actually just ordered some new feeders where I can use, like a water bottle and, like, hold it upside down. I don't know. I ordered it. Y'all will see it. And if you guys have any advice or tips or anything, feel free to leave in the comments. Again, like, I'm new to this. This will be my first year actually doing my own breeding and stuff like that. Again, I just got all these, like, all my brood stock this year. Start off the year right. Start off the year with something different. Yeah, again, I got my big brother out here. Got my big sister out here. That's gotten me out of my room. It got me off the video games. It got me getting more sun. I do plan on going to the gym and stuff like that, especially now that my big brother's here. But for right now, man, I want to raise chickens, and I don't know. It's really cool. It's pretty random, but I don't know, I'm enjoying it. I really like seeing these the birds grow. And I'll just show you what's in this box. I don't know if I want to show you everything yet. Again, we're still waiting on two more birds from Puerto Rico.
I was thinking my life lost color. think I just got bored. I was throwing souls at the dartboard. My daddy wanted me to go to Dartmouth. Opened up a door that wasn't for me like a locksmith. Then I changed the locks, hide the locks. I'm just a pawn inside a box. I ride
here. They're actually like sitting on some eggs and stuff like that. She's a blue krill mix. I didn't know she was a blue krill, but I talked to the breeder. For you guys who do not know what like a krill is kind of like a dom. He kind of has like the pattern on him, kind of krillish. But it's really like this, but more colorful. Again, y'all, I'm new to this. This is my first year, and yeah, this is like bear. And he's actually a Sarama. And then I got my brother's Kikiriki Old English Game Mix. He's a nice looking bird. The Spangle is my favorite color, like pattern or whatever you want to call it. And Spangle are just like the ones with the dots. Some people call it Pintu. Yeah, that's like one of my favorite ones. And then I got some red piles right here. This guy is really nice. He was really fat. He still is kind of fat because they kind of had him in like a little, like a smaller box. A bunch of more chickens. So he flies about 3 feet high in the air and, you know, get some exercise. So he's starting to slim down a little bit. I do want to get a swing eventually, but, oh, look at him. I like her a lot, man. And I had ordered her all the way from Washington. From Mr. Steve Sushi? Mr. Steve Seki? I don't know how to pronounce it. Sorry, Mr. Steve. A really nice bird. And then I got my blacks here. I swear we change the water every day. They just end up scratching it by the ground and getting dirt in it. That's why we gotta change it every day. I pretty much just got all the colors that I really, really like. He's still a young rooster. He's really young. There you go. But he's a nice little guy. Say, do you wanna show them what you got going on with the little pea bantams?
Let's see what we got going on over here.
All right.
You guys trying to bring out the monster. You don't wanna be touched right now. You got some baby girls in here. His honey buns. Out here, boy. This is Brown Red. You know, he's all got a fade, trimmed up, everything rock. Big boy, he's a good bird.
Pure Old English Game Brown Red Rooster.
See, they're actually wondering, what are you doing out there, honey?
I already showed them your Kikiriki.
Oh, Charmitas?
Had an egg, she dropped the egg. I don't know, in the morning she was like picking at it and stuff. It was like cracked open. So, I don't know. And they got nice little condos, man. Like, my brother built that shit. Like, come on, man. You wouldn't put an egg in there. I'd put an egg in there.
I want to guys show you guys, if you can tell me what kind of chicken this is, because we caught it the other day. Nenet.
This is Nenet.
She's a wild pig.
There's no nice way to put it.
We caught her.
And,
she's living it better than ever, I can tell you that much. Let's just say that Nenet gets fed 3 times a day. She has water all the time.
Fresh water.
She has hay all the time. We just cleaned out her cage today.
But really, Nenet's a wild pig, and pretty much we're gonna butcher her eventually.
Holy shit.
I was waiting for my brother to get to the point, but he was slacking there. Yeah, there's no nice way to put it. It's just how it is. Like I said, we are, this is what we do, man. It's like, I don't know how to explain it. It's like a country lifestyle. We eat pig, we go hunting, we catch deer, we eat it.
We go hunting, fishing.
We go fishing.
Everything.
Everything. Like in Hawaii, we would go spearfishing at night, go catch fish, you know, to eat. It's just how my dad was raised too, like living off the land and whatnot, and just doing our thing. You know what I'm saying? We got a lot going on, baby.
We do have a lot going
on. Pound me.
I will. Bro, come on. This shit I'm talking about, bro. Cut it, bro. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Bantam Talk with Matty Ice and Joe Boy. This guy right here, his name's Antonio. We drove 3 hours to get him, thinking that he's a bantam. Comes out to be an ACO bantam. Cross. Good for, what would you say? Chicken noodle soup.
Bro, he's a healthy motherfucker.
I find a lot, I'm low a lot, I shine a lot, I glow a lot, I grow a lot, I know a lot, a little too much. It's all hard, making shoulders touch like I know enough.
All right, guys, I'm about to do a quick comparison for you guys of how Gamefowl is compared to Old English Game Bantam and Kikiriki. And these are all my spangles. This is the Old English Game Bantam rooster right here, and this is a Kikiriki rooster right here, and this is a Rubel Leaper Gamefowl. God dang, he's a little wild. He hasn't really been handled, you know. He has some lady friends, man. You know, who wants to be handled when you got some ladies? You know what I'm saying? You. This is my only game foul rooster that I got personally. My brother has a hand and a rooster and another hand and a couple more roosters. This is gonna be a full size rooster. He's not really standing up for you. And this is gonna be the Old English Game Bantam right here. And this is gonna be the Kikiriki. And you can really see how different they are in size. This is them side by side. You can't even see this guy anymore. And you definitely can't see this guy. You can probably hide this guy behind this guy. But yeah, I just want to show you guys a comparison. A tad bit different. This guy needs to get his comb cut.
You look like a fucking toupee, dog.
A toupee?
No, that ain't too fucking pay. Beret.
A beret.
He's hella small.
Right? And he's small, right? Bruh.
Full size.
Full size. Low ready to breed.
Rider.
He already has kids. He already has kids, guys. He already has kids.
Oh, yeah. This guy's a... He's, no, for real. Young, dumb, full of cum, this guy. I ain't playing.
But yeah, those are just our spangles, man. I just thought I'd do a quick comparison since we're out here showing y'all what we got going on. Again, like I said, guys, we are really new to doing all this stuff. We have been helping our dad raise game fowl and stuff like that. My Puerto Rican kikiriki. So me and my brother today, we cleaned out our little area, our little workshop. We cleaned it up, made it a little organized. And all these chickens they usually sleep on the top of the shelf, but I made it to where they can't go up there. So me and my brother, we decided to freaking put this little thing on, little roost in the middle, so that they could freaking shit on the floor instead of shitting all over the tools and stuff, because they're like trying to like roost over here and yeah. All right, guys, so we're back in my room, and that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys liked it. I have more videos to come. I'm currently editing videos right now as we speak. Yeah, I appreciate you guys all watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, follow my social medias down below. And guess what? I'll see you guys in the next one. Yeah. Stay safe and...